Brighter than the sun. It can smash in buildings, break windows all over town. But if you duck and cover, like Bert, you will be much safer. There are two kinds of attack, with warning and without any warning.
When the war begins, the first thing they do is cut off all the water and all the electricity. So the first thing we should do is keep this filled, use the shower in your room, use the sink downstairs, the garden hose outside.
Those are good ideas. But, Roger, I don't see this as being something you ever have to worry about.
Yeah, but when you hear the sirens, there may not be enough time to fill the tub and the sinks.
Not gonna be any sirens. What is this?
When the bomb comes, the Reds will aim for the Empire State Building. But the bomb goes off at 10,000 feet up. In Life magazine, it's called an airburst. And if the bomb is 50 megatons, the blast wave goes out and out and out and melts everything from here to here, including where we live, here.
But, you know, Roger, no one is dropping atomic bombs on us.
But the Russians want to. Know that Russian guy you're defending? He's here to get things ready for the guys who dropped the bombs.
No, he's not here for that. He's not even Russian. He was born, we think, in Northern England.
Yeah, but he's a spy for Russia. I don't even understand what you're doing. You're not a communist, so why are you defending them?
Well, because it's my job.
Never used to be.